And now for something completely different. In the Netherlands, we have a tradition that we have a poet of the nation, the dichter des vaderlands. We have a thinker of the nation, filosoof des vaderlands, the denker des vaderlands. And we're very proud, we also have a photographer of the nation, the fotograaf des vaderlands. And he is here with us today. Please welcome to the stage the lovely duo of Jan-Dirk van den Burg and Flavia Vaas.
Slideshow to a new dimension. Here we go. This is Ollie. Ollie is an icon in the world of smaller rodents and an expert of hairy guinea pigs. It's a niche market, but an important one. And this is Rolof. He goes already 20 years under the slogan, there's always more air than tree, which is true. And this is Jan Gravenmaker, Holland's only steam locomotive engineer, with his initials on the side, JG. And this is in Betondorp, an interpretation of the theme After Party. And this is Han Klein Haneveld. You probably know him better under his nickname, Han Zeitspan or Han Sidecar. He loves the smell of burning rubber. Me too. And this is Jorgos. Jorgos is the owner of the smallest comb over in the world. Kind of lambiek hair, but then comb over your skull. And this is Ron. Ron is a Dutch donut baker. And for every time he won the national donut baking competition, the AD Oliebollen test, he added an extra diamond in his golden ice scoop. Five times. And this is Connie. She never won the national donut baking competition. And this is Geert. Geert really loves dancing. He loves it. And here comes Cherise. She also likes dancing, but prefers twirling, especially in the suit of her mother. And this is Dick. Dick is he has at home a digital pinball machine with 287 games in one machine. And his favorite game is AC/DC, Thunderstruck. And this is a diptych on checkered blouses or on green jackets, or a diptych on khaki pants or on sandals, whatever kind of diptych you like to choose. And this is a triptych about checkered blouses. I always like to work in a series, much more impact. And this is Mario Lang with Show Pony Donar. That's an Argentinian miniature pony who can dance on his hind legs. And this is Mark Heldens. Mark is the biggest ball pen collector of the north of Limburg. He has at home 100,000 pens, and his wife Toast collects coffee milk cup lids. It's big in Switzerland. Thank you. Okay, yeah, we were asked to spice things up. For this disruptive portfolio presentation, I was awarded 8 months ago, and I got the fancy title, Photographer of the Nation. Yeah. Yeah, you don't get anything with that title. I had to buy this on race horsing prices and cattle prices, but it looks nice. But yeah, the one thing, yeah, when we're just between us, there was one very important thing that I didn't tell that committee. Because like already for 2 years, I hardly leave the house to make pictures. I still observe humanity, but more how humanity and its human behavior presents itself to me in my laptop and on my iPhone. Really, we upload 6 million pictures every day on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, and yeah, I'm already a voyeuristic person, but I really can't resist, and I still make series. I collect all that images with
Command Shift 4, the shortcut if you have an Apple to make a screenshot and put that in a better perspective actually. Just at home. Well, maybe I can give you, the best thing is to give you an example of my daily routine. 8 months ago I was thinking about to photograph a prize-winning billiard player. And I thought, well, just very fast, just look on the internet what's already there. And I did that and I ended up in a wormhole of the most beautiful pictures of billiard players that they already made themselves. In 2.5 hours, I had a beautiful document of the Netherlands playing billiard and winning prizes. It's all different shapes and forms. You know, what can I add to this? Why should I leave the house? The competition and the award ceremony is always under the sectational ceiling. That's also a Dutch icon that's very, very important. Yeah, and this is one of my favorites. You can see it's like 5 people who wear those beautiful patterns of checkered blouses. And they all 5, they have the same size award, except of the guy over here. He has 2 awards and the biggest smile. I really like that. Yeah, or that day that I stumbled upon this picture. This is an elderman, a bethouder from the city of Gouda. And he has that funny crew cut, that upstanding gray hair. I also had that when I was 12. But then on that same night, I started to investigate this for 2.5 hours. And I already could draw the spectacular conclusion that it's apparently a trend under aldermen of middle-sized municipalities to wear gray crew cuts. Why? I never see that in real life. You can only observe this on the internet. And yeah, well, we have some different categories. We have the blockhead. Blockhead that's boyish, dynamic, energetic. Be careful if you stop smiling on pictures, it can be a little bit aggressive at first. This is the hedgehog variant, that's the upstanding hair over the whole skull. You see that in north of Holland. And this is the most popular variant. This is the firm carré on top of the head, but then with the sides still covered, so you can combine that energetic approach with a little bit of statesmanship. Yeah, this is another hair trend that I find on the internet. These are girls who post pictures of themselves with their hair just right across their faces. You never see that in real life, that you're talking with a girl and she has her whole face covered with hair, but on the internet it's the highest aesthetic grill, apparently to show the half of your face. Yeah. Please, can I see some hands of girls who do this on the internet? No one? Well, let's go to another Instagram trend. These are guys who post pictures under the hashtag nephew with a borrowed child, as you can see. But they secretly have a double agenda. Because first they want to, expose their masculinity even more, see? And on every picture that they post, the nephew is there, but always playing second fiddle. Please, some hands of guys who post pictures on the hashtag nephew. No. I have to get back to the internet. Oh yeah, and this is my series. It's nice. It's undertakers who decided to advertise with pictures with a very big smile. Yeah, you see that in Brabant a lot. Apparently it's literal version of a happy end, I guess, but yeah. Yeah. But this guy is doubting, I think. You know, the rest is like, ah, ha, ha, and he's, Yeah, or this is the theory, principals of elementary schools who are or surprised that they are principal of elementary school, or even more surprised that they could also join the school photographer. One of those, yeah, crazy. I could, just my laptop. Oh yeah, yeah. And this is a trend I wanted to discuss with you, because yeah, these are sex workers, especially in Amsterdam, because it's a phenomenon. They are not behind the glass, the window of the red light district anymore. No, they're behind the glass of my laptop. And they made their own profiles. And for some peculiar reason, they're always posing up, under, or next to a radiator. A radiator. It's a perfect place to show off your... it's always, when you see a profile, there's a radiator in it. Yeah, we can distinguish a few categories. Yeah, this is the type 10 plate radiator. That's, yeah, if you have the in the smallest, yeah, smallest spaces of the house, in the hallway, in the room, it really can be used very nicely to show off some legwork. You can use it really as a pedestal. Nice. Yeah, and then we have the column radiator, or the so-called Victorian radiator. You see that more in historical buildings if you want to have a more historical approach to your, yeah, if you have some domestic sustainability goals, don't go for the Victorian radiator. Yeah, try to see a design radiator. Yeah, and this is the type that you actually see the most. It's type 33, that is with, as you can see here, with three plates and three convectors next to each other. The biggest artillery that you can bring on to the cold front. Maximum warmth capacity, maximum pressure on the extension tank. Oh, yeah. And here we're back with the gray crew cut. It's a vicious circle. But guys, seriously, if I can find this in my laptop, I hardly use the extension shutter of my camera anymore. It's... Yeah, I once became a photographer to travel the world and capture the peculiar conduct of mankind in all its forms. But since that peculiar human behavior takes place on a platform that me and my camera can't reach, it's quite logical, right, that I divert into a slightly different direction and just stay home. Make my series there.
Aidan, when the sky is filled with clouds, know that the sun still shines above. Turn your face towards the sun, and the shadows fall behind you. Know who you are, I know it's enough. Live your life with a still unwritten. You can shake the the sand from your shoes. But not from your soul. Mess with the bull, you'll get the horns when life gives you lemons. When life gives you lemons, when life gives you.
Clap your hands, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you.
Thanks.
Yeah, thank you so much. Cool.
Yeah.
Yes, and you always go to work in your pajamas?
Yeah, I stay home.
Yeah, very good.
I don't have an office anymore. It's just at my kitchen table. I can do everything that I want.
Right.
As a photographer.
And this is your pajamas as well?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah. This is my skin. I was born in this.
Yeah.
I love it. If you want to know more about your work, where should we go?
To jandirk.com.
Jandirk.com.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for being here.
All right.
Woohoo!
Thank you.